This is our lecture number 3 of first unit of the 10th class, that is chemical reactions and chemical equations. Now this is our third lecture. Question is, write different types of chemical reactions. So chemical reaction, as we know, it is the phenomenon or the representation of the way by which reactant combine to give you the product. So types of chemical reactions, they are of many types. Number one, combination reactions. These are the reactions where two reactants combine together to give you the product. For example, calcium oxide, white washing wala jo chuna hai, that is calcium oxide. This is called as quicklime. Reacts with water to give you calcium hydroxide. Carbon solid combines with O2 gas to give you CO2 gas. This is to be ignited. Ignition is done in this case. So these reactions are combination reactions where two reactants, they are combining together to give you the product. Then we have 2H2 gas combines with O2 gas to give you 2H2O liquid. This can be done by heating or by electric spark. This reaction can be brought by electric spark. Then we have the combustion of methane, which is used as a fuel in industry as well as in commercial domestic purposes also. It combines with oxygen, again ignite it to give you CO2 plus 2 water. Plus heat is evolved in this reaction. In this case also heat is produced. So this is gas, this is gas, this is gas, this is liquid air. So these are the combination reactions where reactant combine to give you the product. Similarly, we have the combustion of your oxidation of glucose in our body. That is also a combination reaction, C6H12O6, that burns in the presence of oxygen to give you 6O2 plus 6 water. Oxygen is here 18, here we are having 6 oxygen, so it will be that. This is oxidation of glucose. So delta H plus heat is evolved, and this heat is used up in carrying out the bodily activities, the cellular activities. They are to be performed by the energy so produced in the body. Then we have the second type of reactions. They are called as decomposition reactions. Decomposition reactions are those reactions where a single reactant decomposes to give you the product. For example, we have 2FeSO4, it is strongly heated, we will get Fe2O3 plus SO2 plus O2 gas. So FeSO4, when heated strongly, it breaks up to give you Fe2O3, we get SO2, we get SO3 from this reaction by decomposition. Similarly, when limestone CaCO3 is heated, they are solid. This is solid, these are gases. It breaks up to give you CaO solid plus CO2 gas. So these reactions, they are called as decomposition reactions because they are decomposing, because the reactants are decomposing in these reactions. Similarly, we have 2PbNO3 twice, lead nitrate on heating will give you 2PbO plus 4NO2 plus oxygen. So we are having 12 oxygen here, 2 here, 8, 10. So we are having 12 oxygen. So these three reactions, they represent the decomposition reaction. So this is the second variety of decomposition reactions. Then we have fourth example. That is a reaction of photography that is done in the presence of light reflected by the object. it start decomposing as 2Ag plus Cl2, and this gives the image of the object. So this is our reaction of photography. हार्ड पेपर के ऊपर फोटोग्राफ लिया जाता है जहाँ पर AgCl डिकम्पोज होके ये इमेज ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट पार्टली इमेज ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट पार्शली बना देता है विच इज लेटर ऑन डेवलप्ड. दिस रिएक्शन इज ऑल्सो परफॉर्म्ड बाय 2AgBr फ्रॉम द फोटोग्राफिक सेलुलॉयड फिल्म इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ लाइट इट ब्रेक्स अप टू गिव यू 2Ag plus Br2. दिस इज एक्चुअली reaction which is taking your photograph on the celluloid film. This reaction is the reaction during developing where that image has been developed in the form of a perfect image on the art paper there that is coated by AgCl in that case. Then after doing these two types of reactions, now we come to the third type of reaction. They are called as displacement reactions. As you know, displace means to remove of one substance. So in these reactions, a metal displaces another metal, or a non-metal displaces non-metal, or sometimes metal displaces non-metal. So these reactions, they are called as displacement reactions. So this is our third type of reaction. They are called as displacement reactions. So what are displacement reactions? In these reactions, one of the reactant displace another reactant from the other reactant. For example, when we dip zinc rod in a copper sulfate blue colored solution, this is copper sulfate solution, aqueous solution which is blue in color, this is your gray colored. Now zinc combines with sulfate ion to give you zinc sulfate, which is colorless, it is not having any color, and copper settles at bottom, so blue color disappears. This reaction is called as metal displacement, because here one metal, that is zinc, displaces copper from copper sulfate solution and gives you the product ZnSO4 plus Cu in this case. Then we have the second type of reactions where non-metal is displaced. So that reaction is also called as displacement reaction. Then we have Pb combining with CuCl2 to give you PbCl2 plus Cu. Cu has been kept out. Similarly, zinc combines with sulfuric acid. Here, the non-metal is to be displaced by zinc. You get ZnSO4 plus H2 in this case. Similarly, if you are combining zinc with 2HNO3, again a non-metal part is to be displaced, ZnNO3 twice plus hydrogen gas. So these are the non-metal, metal non-metal displacement reaction. These are metal displacement reactions. So these are the reactions. Then we have double displacement reaction, where both of the reactants, they displace one another, they mutually displace each other. For example, we have the double displacement. For example, Na2SO4 is combining with barium chloride. So sodium displaces barium here and get NaCl. Barium displaces sodium from the other side, we get BaSO4. So this is a double displacement reaction. Similarly, we can write AgNO3 combining with NaCl to give you AgCl plus NaNO3. This is also a double displacement reaction. And then in these reactions, both of the metallic elements, they are displacing mutually, they are displacing each other. So these are called as double displacement reactions. Then we have the other types of reactions. This is our third variety of reactions. Then we have the addition reactions. These are just similar to the combination reaction, where the two reactants they get added together to give the product. So we have fourth variety of reaction, that is addition reactions, where two reactants get added together. Ethylene here adding a molecule of hydrogen in the presence of nickel at 475 Kelvin to give you ethane. This is addition reaction. Then we have condensation reaction. In condensation reaction, what happens here? The two molecules, they will combine together, eliminating a water molecule here. They are combining here with HCl, eliminating a water molecule here. Product is C2H5 here. This is condensation. Then we have elimination reaction. Here, one molecule is eliminated from a molecule. This is ethyl alcohol. It is treated with concentrated sulfuric acid. It eliminates a water molecule and gives you ethylene. Then we have the polymerization reaction. Here, the small molecules, which are called as monomers, combine together under high pressure and low temperature. This is high pressure and low temperature of 1000 atmosphere here, and low temperature the molecules combine to give big molecule. This is called as polymer. So these are the different varieties of your chemical reactions which we studied in the first unit here. Now we come to another variety of reactions. They are called as redox reactions. Redox reactions are those which are involving reduction as well as oxidation, both. So this concept can be understood by understanding if there is a donor to donate something, there must be a beggar to accept something. So in oxidation, what happens? The species that supplies oxygen to other substance. In reduction, that species accepts oxygen from that substance. In terms of electrons, we can say oxidation is the process which involves loss of electron, and reduction is the process which involves gain of electron. Both of these processes, they will be held together. They occur simultaneously. So one cannot separate reduction from oxidation and oxidation from reduction. For example, we have the reaction here. CuO combines with hydrogen to give you Cu plus water. Here, this is an oxidizing agent. It is supplying oxygen. The agent which supplies oxygen is oxidizing agent. Which takes oxygen is reducing agent. After losing oxygen, it is said to be reduced, and this is said to be oxidized. And from CuO to Cu, you have carried out oxidation. Then H2 to H2O, you have carried out oxidation. This is carried out a reduction. Loss of oxygen is reduction also. So now we come to another reaction, ZnO combining with carbon, giving you Zn plus CO. This is oxidizing agent, reducing agent. This is said to be reduced. This is said to be oxidized. So this is the process. Here oxygen is added. This process is oxidation. Here oxygen is lost. This process is reduction. So these are the last variety of reactions. They are called as the redox reaction or reduction oxidation reactions. Then we have corrosion of iron. Now what is corrosion or rusting of iron? Now what is corrosion or what is rusting of iron? So our question is, what is corrosion or rusting of iron? Corrosion or rusting of iron is the deterioration of metal surface when it is exposed to moist air, or it is exposed to the aqueous solution of salts. What happens during that process? These salts, they get ionized, or the moist air which contains carbon dioxide and sulfur dioxide, these gases, they dissolve in water to produce the weak acid like carbonic acid and sulfurous acid. These acids ionize to produce H positive ions. These H positive ions, they are electron deficient, so then they start exciting the provoking iron to lose electron. Iron loses electron to protons, which get converted to water in the presence of oxygen, and iron ion passes into the solution, and later on in solution they get converted into oxide form, which is called as rust. Rust is actually hydrated ferric oxide. So what is the rusting or corrosion? It is the deterioration of metal surface on exposure to moist air contaminated with, जिसके अंदर होते हैं CO2 और SO2 और sometimes salts. So this iron will get converted into your Fe2O3 hydrated, that is called as rust. Now what are the reactions? First of all, H2O combines with CO2 to produce carbonic acid. And these carbonic acids, they get ionized to produce H positive ions and HCO3 negative ions. These H positive ions, they are in the need of electron. They will go to iron and will demand for these electrons. And these electrons, they are taken by H positive ions in the presence of O2 to give you 2H2. Now to balance this equation, we have to add here 4 electrons are made here, and here this equation is divided by, multiplied by 2. So we get now 2Fe plus 4H positive, 4 electrons they are being cancelled here, plus O2, you get 2Fe 2 positive plus 2H2O. These Fe 2 positive ions, they pass into the solution. In the presence of proton, water and oxygen to give you 2Fe2O3 plus 8 protons are produced. These Fe2O3, this is rust, it combines with X number of water molecule to give you rust. So this is rust. Now what are the methods to prevent rusting? We know it can be prevented by barrier protection, by applying paint on the iron article surface, or by coating its surface with grease or with oil. We can check rusting, because that will cut the supply of this moist air to the air, and loss of electron, that is to be prevented by iron. Second is by sacrificial protection. We coat the surface of iron with zinc paint, zinc is this phenomena is called as galvanization. Here in preference to iron, zinc will lose electron and will get consumed during the process. Till it is there, it will prevent iron from rusting. So it will sacrifice itself for the iron. That's why it is also called as sacrificial production. Then third, we have electrical production. The ships you see, they always remain in the salty water in the sea. The salty water that helps in the rusting, we have already written that in the presence of salt, the ship, bottom of the ship, it can be rusted and the ship will get spoiled. So what is done there, we hang magnesium blocks with the help of wire at the bottom of the ship. These magnesium blocks, they supply electrons to H positive ions in place of Fe and prevent iron from rusting. So with the passage of time, these magnesium blocks, they get consumed, so they ought to be replaced from time to time to prevent rusting at the ship bottom. Then we have the next phenomenon that is called as rancidity. Question number 3 is, what is rancidity? How it can be prevented? So rancidity, it is the spoiling up of the fats or oils. They are oxidized by the atmospheric air and they become rancid. And their smell and taste and behavior that changes. Usually the substances which prevent against the rancidity, they are called as antioxidants. They are added to the packets of the substances which are sold in the packets or to the food items which are sold in the packing wrappers. So now usually these substances, they are added to the foods containing fats and oil, keeping food in a airtight containers, which help to slow down the oxidation process and it prevents the appearance of rancidity in the fats or oils, and the quality of fats and oil that is not disturbed at all. We know that chips manufacturers usually flush bags of the chips with gas such like nitrogen to prevent chips from the oxidation, to prevent chips from being spoiled. They are flushed with the nitrogen gas prior to the storage, so they prevent the rancidity or the spoilage of these chips. And these chips, they retain their quality for a long time. So rancidity is the loss of quality by fats and oils due to their oxidation by atmospheric air and some other oxidants like metal oxide, dust particles, etc. So it can be prevented by flushing the bags of the chips or some food articles with nitrogen, which will prevent, which will preserve their quality and prevent them from the oxidation. In the food items, we add sodium benzoate, sodium meta bisulfite to preserve their qualities. So this is all about our unit number 1 of the 10th class. Tomorrow we'll take with the second unit of the 10th class. That will be acid, bases and salt. Thank you very much.